When it comes to down-home cooking at its finest, it's hard to beat Cleburne Cafeteria.
Probably in 73, so I've been coming since then.
A part of Houston's history for almost 80 years, the inspiration for this treasured restaurant goes back generations.
My father is a Greek immigrant. America was the land of opportunity. There was really nothing left after the Second World War for so many people on the island.
Nick Michaelis came to Houston after World War II with only a couple of dollars in his pocket and a dream to make a better life.
He said, "George, I didn't speak much English, so I didn't do much talking, and that's why I was washing dishes for the most part."
But in 1952, Nick's wife, Pat, saw an ad in the paper that caught her eye.
She found the Cleburne Cafeteria for sale in the newspaper by two little old ladies, and she says, "Nick, you got to buy this place."
Together, they bought the cafeteria on Cleburne Street back then and raised their family in the same building.
I was actually born upstairs above a cafeteria. My folks lived upstairs and worked downstairs.
Working in the cafeteria became a family tradition.
Even at 10 or 11 years old, I was peeling potatoes, onions and carrots and helping out.
And customers became family too, moving right along with Cleburne in the 1960s when it relocated to Bissonette Street.
Cleburne Cafeteria has really stood the test of time here in Houston. Twice it was destroyed by fire, twice it was rebuilt, and now it's back and better than ever before.
We had one almost 30 years ago and one about 4 years ago. This last fire took us almost 2 years to rebuild from.
Though all was lost, Cleburne Cafeteria reopened in 2018 with an expanded dining room and kitchen and all the old comfort classics that made it an icon.